York Love. Until 1910, the U.S. was considered a mission country. After 1910, the bishops declared, no, we are a mission sending country. And so the bishops got together and they created Merriam. I don't know if you ever heard of Merriam, but the formal title is the Catholic Foreign Mission Society of America. We call it Merriam because you can't remember all that. And its only purpose is to represent the U.S. Catholic Church outside the United States in the mission territory. So first we were in China, and we moved on. I was in the Philippines for 25 years. My work there was able to be done by local people and to move on. So I went to Africa, Namibia, it's way in the southwest of Africa. Now I'm here. Just to remind you about what the mission's all about. The fact that we have all of our work overseas makes it a little difficult here. How do we get our bread and butter? How do we get our plane ticket? All of that. We are totally dependent on the parishioners in the United States. And it's important for us to keep you in touch with what's going on. That's why Merriam is this magazine. Your grandmothers used to get this. I don't know about you. Okay? Comes in English, and there's a Spanish version also. There's a bunch in the back, 8-2. But this is the only way we have of keeping you up to date, what we're doing. Because I'm working in your name. You're the bosses. You might have forgotten that, but you are the U.S. Catholic Church, not me. So when I go overseas, it's representing you. Man, could you grab some of those envelopes in the back, along with those little pencils? You want to see if everyone here knows how to read and write. But no, man's going to give you an envelope. They're big envelopes, so they hold a lot. This is so that you can keep getting the magazine. Okay, today you get one free, but we do need your name and address. It's the only way of getting we have contact. If you can do something on a regular, monthly basis, mark that down. That's what really keeps us going. If you have your checkbook, take it out to the parish, or make it out to Marianne, it doesn't matter. Do what you can. If you can't do it today, take it home with you. And maybe send it to Denise later, okay? On the back, down in the corner, there's room for your prayers. Again, if you have prayers, please let us know so we can pray with you. Notice I say pray with, not just pray to or pray for. It's important that we pray for you as much as you pray for us. I don't know about here. I know my dad's parish down in Tampa, Florida. He's 90 years old, so I get to stay with him a little bit now. But every week they pray for all of the service people overseas defending our country. That's good. But I never hear them pray for our missionaries. Somehow we've forgotten about missionaries and think U.S. people overseas only carry guns. That's not true at all. We also carry God's word. So whenever you hear someone praying for the military, think in your heads, missionaries as well. If Dumas is getting too small and you want to explore the world, think about becoming a missionary. Your knees are better than my knees. So I know you can climb those mountains. But no, honestly, especially your grandkids, single or married, young or old, a lot of opportunities for helping out overseas. So once sister teaches you how to help the poor, then you come and look for the real poor. Okay, you'll find overseas. Thank you for all you can do. Don't forget the parish, though. I'm going to make your own contributions here. Nate, did you get an envelope?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, don't put it in there. Don't stick it in. You're supposed to use that envelope.
Stick it home with me.
Take the pencils home with you, I know. but just throw that in the regular basket. And we'll separate that. So, good. Thank you. You need help. My people are out for you. Okay. No, thank you so much. God bless. Just glad I had the opportunity to come today. Looks like your neighbors were worried no priest was coming. But you're special to us because you're all the Shall we stand and profess our faith?